हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल ई बॉटनी। लुक एट दिस पिक्चर। दिस पिक्चर शोज दैट देयर इज अ सीड जर्मिनेशन। ओके, नाउ द आफ्टर दिस सीड जर्मिनेशन द वेरियस स्टेजेस वी आर ऑब्जर्विंग अप टू प्लांटलेट्स। नाउ हियर दिस इज द सिक्वेंशियल प्रोसेस इन विच द टोटल इंक्रीज इन साइज, okay, increase in the size of a cell, expansion of a cell or the expansion of a leaf and the elongation of a stem. Now here the actual size, mass, volume of that cell become increases. Now here this shows that the growth, here the growth is nothing but the irreversible permanent process in which the increase in the size, mass, volume of that cell. So in the last video we have already discussed about the growth. Now in this video we are discussing about the development. So the growth and development, it is the part second. Now the development. Now here look at this video again. Now here what happened? The seed grows, roots get sprout, it grows and grows. Okay, after the growth it develop leaves, formation of flowers get bloom. Okay, after that the fruit formation, pollination occur. Okay, and the fruits get fall down. Okay, so seeds get again fall on the floor, so they get again germinate. Now this is the exact process. Now what happened? Now what is this? This is nothing but the development. So development is the sequential process of a seed germination. Okay, after the seed germination, that is a cell elongation, cell differentiation and the cell maturation. Okay, it is the also process the cell differentiation, that means specialized function. Okay, each cell having some special function. Then it is a flower formation. Then after the flower formation, that is a fruit formation, and the fruit formation, after the completion of the fruit formation, fruit and the seed formation, the senescence. So the development is the sequential process of a seed germination, the differentiation of the cell, okay, cell expansion, the flower formation, seed formation, fruit formation and the senescence. This is nothing but the overall we call as a development. Okay, now that means development is the sequence of events that occur in the life history of a plant, which include the seed germination, growth, differentiation, maturation, flowering, seed formation and the senescence. That means this is the summation of all these events we call as a development. Now this development is the term which include all the changes which are occur on that organism. That means from during the life cycle, that means from to the germination up to the senescence. That means at the senescence means that is aging of that plant. So from to the seed germination up to the aging, there are the number of the sequential changes which are occur we call as a development. So in the first slide, in the first video we have already studied that there are the three phases of a growth, like as a cell division, cell expansion and the cell maturation. Now here the undifferentiated cell, that means we call as a meristematic cells, get differentiated and with the help of cell division. Okay, that means cells get divides and redivides. Now this, after the division, undifferentiated cells, after the division, these cells get expand. Expand means we say that is elongation in their size. Okay, so mass, volume get elongate. So after the elongation, these cells get matured, and this matured cells has developed the ability for perform a specific function. Now this mature cell, this mature cell get differentiated, and after the differentiated, the whole life history become a complete. So this mature cell get get again converted into the senescence. Now that means here the aging of that plants, and here the total process become a decreases in the senescence. So aging of that plant, there is a complete retardation. Okay, there is a complete this is the natural process of the senescence, that is aging, and then after the aging there is a death of that plants. So this is the sequence of the developmental process which are occur in the plant cell, which is starting from meristematic cells, various phases of the growth, then mature cell form, then senescence and the death. Now these are the sequential events of the development. Now the development is nothing but the nothing but the sum of two process. One is that the growth, and second is that the differentiation. Okay, that means it is the summation of these two process. Growth, we know that growth is a irreversible permanent process. That means here there is an increase in the cell size, mass, volume. Okay, some increase in the size, mass, volume of that cell. And the differentiation means, that means here these cells they develop the special function. They form a special function for at a particular location. So these cells are a matured cell. Now here what happened in the development? Development is a complex body organization. Okay, that means it form in the development, there is a formation of a complex body from simple body. That means the formation of a complex body organization means this is a seed. When we are sown into the soil, at that time seed get germinate and it form a root. Okay, now this is the root. Now then again it get grows and it form a complete leaf structure. Okay, leaf structure, formation of a leaf. Okay, the leaf get expand. Okay, there are the number of branches are formed. After the complete maturation of these plants, it form a flowering, fruiting, then fruits get developed into the seed, and then after the last stage, that means they are eventually they die. Now here this is the simple form, that means seed is a simple form, and here the seed get germinate and it form a complex body organization. Now this is the process, that means development is the process of a formation of a complex body organization. That means like as a roots, leaf, flower, branches, seeds. Okay, and this is nothing but the development. Here these all cells get developed from to the zygote. Okay, the zygote form a new cells. Now the zygote produces number of the cells and which organize the tissues and the organ. Now single cells get divides, redivides, it form a tissue. Now these tissues get come together, number of tissues get come together, it form a organ. Now this is a simple, now this is a simple body organization, that is a single cell get converted into the complex. Complex body organization. Now here we say that this is a complete, this is a development. Now the one more phenomena is that the plasticity and the heterophily, which is completely related to the development. Now the plasticity, here the ability of a plant to the to follow the different pathways and produce a different structure in response to the environment and the phases of a life. That means according to the environment, according to the response of a response to the environment and the phases of a life, the plant follow the different pathways. Okay, why? For to the production of a different kind of a structure. So for example, in the cotton or the coriander, we know that the coriander, okay, coriander plants, the leaves of the leaves of the juvenile plants are different in a shape, and those are in a mature plants. Okay, that means at the juvenile phase, this leaves structure, that means size, shape of the leaves become a different, while as in the adult it may be it become a completely different from the juvenile stage. So here in these two stages, juvenile and the adult stage, they the size and the shape of that leaf become not become a same. So here we say here the plasticity. Now what happened? They at the juvenile stage there is a different shape, while as at the adult stage there is a different shape. Now here it occurs due to the plasticity. Now the why, you know, how they occur? Because of the plant follow the different pathways. Why follows? Because of this is the response to the environment and the various phases of a life. So the different structure of a leaf we are observe in the coriander. Now same phenomena is that the heterophylly. Now the heterophylly, this is the phenomena appearance of a different forms of a leaves on a same plant. On a single same plant we are found the different kind of a leaves. Okay, such a kind of leaves we are also found on the coriander also. Okay, this kind of the leaves on the mature plant we are observing such a kind of leaves, such a kind of leaves, such a kind of leaves. Okay, so this is the different kind of the forms we are found on the same plant. It is called as a heterophylly. So these are the two concepts which are properly observed, okay, which are easily observed in the plant. So this is the plasticity, and the second is that the heterophylly, which is occur because of the response to the environment and the phases of a life. Now the factors affecting on the development, that means the factors are very very essential. So there are the that means they control the all the activities. So development of the plant get control under the two kind of the factors. One is that the intrinsic factor and second is that the extrinsic factors. Now the intrinsic factors are completely related to the inner side factors. Now inner side factor we call as the some plant growth regulators. We call as a PGR, we call as a phytohormones, we call as a plant hormones. Okay, now these are the some chemicals which are found on the plants, or they get synthesized into the plants, and these factors are essential for to the development, called as a intrinsic factors. Now the second is that the extrinsic factors, that means the light, temperature, water, oxygen and the nutrient. These are the outsider factors which affect the growth and which affect on the development of that plants. Now we are focusing on the plant growth regulators or the plant growth hormones. Okay, now what is plant growth regulators? The plant growth regulators are the chemicals, are the small simple molecules of a diverse chemical composition. These are the complete small simple molecules which is having a diverse chemical composition. Now these phytohormones are a chemical substances, okay, that influence on the growth and the differentiation of a plant cell, tissues and the organ. That means the main exact role of the phytohormones is the on the cell, tissue and the organ. That means here the changes which are occur in the cell, tissues and organ, which is due to the plant growth regulators. These plant growth regulators function as a chemical messenger for to the intercellular communication. Now intercellular communication, that is cell to cell communication. Now this cell to cell communication is occurred with the help of plant growth regulators. Okay, they work together and coordinating the growth and the development of the cell. That means these are the plant growth regulator is the intrinsic factors which plays an important role at the time of development. Now there are the five kinds of phytohormones, like as auxin, gibberellins, cytokinin, abscisic acid and the ethylene. These are the five phytohormones which are present in the plants. Now these five hormones get classified into two category. Now first is that the growth promoter and second is that the growth inhibitor. Now out of these five hormones, the three are a growth promoter and the two are a inhibitors. Now the three, like as auxin, gibberellins and the cytokinin, these three hormones are a growth promoter, and the abscisic acid and the ethylene are the growth inhibitors. Now what is the meaning of growth promoter? That means they promote the growth. That means auxin, gibberellin and the cytokinin, they promote the growth, while as the abscisic acid and the ethylene, they inhibit the growth. So these are the five hormones and their classification. Now we are focusing on the comparative function of the plant hormones on the plant what is the exact role of the hormones on the plant development. So these are the five hormones, like as auxin, gibberellic acid, cytokinin, abscisic acid and the ethylene. Now here the auxin plays an important role in the root development. That means this plus sign indicates that means they promote, and negative that means they inhibit. So here the auxin promote the root development. That means here, that's why the root root shows the constant increase in their length. Okay, so the auxin promote the root development, the extension of a growth, the size, the plant increase in their size, increase in their height. Okay, they expand their size, expand their leaf structure. It is occur due to the auxin. At the juvenility phase, the auxin promote the juvenility. That is at the younger stage, the plants the juvenility stage is promoted by the auxin. While as the at the flower formation, the auxin plays an important role. Okay, so they promote the flowering as well as the fruit development. So the fruit development and the flowering is promoted by the auxin. And the one more is that the senescence. Senescence means that is the aging of that plants. Okay, the senescence is also promoted. That means here the auxin promote the senescence, while as the auxin inhibit the dormancy. Now dormancy, what is the meaning of dormancy? Dormancy means the inability of that or the inactive stage of the seed. Okay, so this is all metabolic and metabolic processes get stopped. So this is called as a dormancy. So for to that dormancy, that means this dormancy is inhibited by the auxin. Now this is the auxin. Second is that one more thing is that auxin also plays a role in the shoot apical meristem and the root apical meristem. Okay, that means at the with the help of a cytokinin, they plays an important role. Okay, so second thing is that the gibberellic acid, that is a GA is a gibberellic acid, they promote the root development as well as they also extend the, they also plays an important role in the growth extension. Okay, now that means cell enlarge in their size, while as the juvenile phase is promoted by the growth by the gibberellic acid, as well as they also take part in the promotion of a flowering and the fruiting development and the senescence also. Okay, so and the one more thing is that they promote the dormancy. So gibberellic acid is promote the dormancy. So gibberellic acid is that means promote the dormancy. We say that they this gibberellic acid plays an important role in the breakdown of the dormancy, so the seed get easily germinate. Now the third thing is that the cytokinin is having a cytokinin, the here the that is a cell division. Now the cytokinin plays an important role in the shoot and root development as well as the extension of a growth. Okay, the cell size, volume, mass become an increase due to the cytokinin. Okay, the juvenility phase is inhibited by the cytokinin, and the flowering phase as well as fruit development, senescence and the dormancy is promoted by the cytokinin. Okay, so here the cytokinin is plays an important role in these functions. Okay, now the abscisic acid. Now abscisic acid called as a stress hormone. Now this stress hormone they doesn't have the any role in the root development, but in the extension of a growth they plays an important role, while as in the flower and the fruit development. Okay, abscisic acid is the stress hormone, and this stress hormone plays an important role in the flowering and the fruiting as well as to the breakdown of the dormancy. So this is the abscisic acid, and the last is that the ethylene. Now ethylene is called as a fruit ripening hormone. Now here fruit ripening hormone, because the ethylene is a gaseous hormone and which are essential for to the fruit ripening. Okay, So as well as they are also useful, they are also take a part in the root development as well as growth expansion, okay, as well as in the flowering, fruiting, senescence and the dormancy. And they doesn't have the any role in the or they inhibit or the, there is a very minor role in the juvenility. So these are the comparison between the different five different hormones. Okay, that is auxin, gibberellic acid, cytokinin, abscisic acid, and the ethylene. Now this is the exact floral chart which indicate that the various hormones and their roles. Okay, now the first, look at this. This is the seed. Now the seed, this dormant seed get ruptured. Okay, now this dormant seed with the help of gibberellic acid, they break down this dormant seed and the embryo, that means this zygote, divides and redivides. Okay, so seed coat get break down and after then the divides and the redivides of the embryo, so it get germinate and the formation of a radical. Okay, now here the abscisic acid inhibit the formation of a radical, but gibberellic acid plays an important role in the seed germination. Now then the second thing is the root development. What are the, which of the hormones the plays an important role, like as a gibberellic acid, auxin, okay, ethylene, auxin, gibberellic acid, while as cytokinin, abscisic acid and ethylene, they now here in the root elongation, now this is the root elongation, here the cytokinin, abscisic acid and ethylene, they inhibit the root elongation, while as the gibberellic acid and the auxin, they promote the root elongation, while as the shoot elongation is promoted by the ethylene, auxin and the gibberellic acid, while as a leaf expansion is promoted by the gibberellic acid and the jasmonic acid. So this is a root and the shoot development. Now here the shoot apical meristem development. Now the shoot apical meristem development, the cytokinin plays an important role because cytokinin have the ability, that is a cell division. So at the apex of the root and the apex of the shoot, the at the both session, the RAM, RAM and the SAM, they plays an important role. In here the cytokinin plays an important role and therefore there is a expansion, there is a the apex region get grow. Okay, so here auxin and the gibberellic acid, they inhibit. Okay, so due to that inhibition the lateral bud get grow. Okay, now this is the shoot and the shoot apical meristem development. Now the expansion of the shoot, now the expansion of a shoot promoted by the auxin and the gibberellic acid, while as cytokinin and the ethylene get inhibited this shoot expansion. Now in the flower development, the flower formation is promoted by the gibberellic acid, auxin, cytokinin. Okay, but basic role of the gibberellic acid, while as with the presence of the abscisic acid, the flower development is inhibited. So this is the flower development. Now these are the hormones which plays an important role in the various stages of the growth and the development. So these are the phytohormones which are essential for to the development of that plant body. Now then when we looking the growth versus the development, here we observe that growth is a quantitative phenomena in which the number, size and the volume increase. Only the number, size and volume increase in the growth, while as the development is the qualitative phenomena in which there is the emergence of a specialized body part for a specialized function. Now in it, the cell get divides, redivides, here the number and the size of that cell become increased, but after the maturation of that cell, these cells perform specific function we call as a development. So the development is a qualitative phenomena and the growth is an the quantitative phenomena. Now, the development or the plant growth is affected by the six plant processes. Okay. Now, which are the six plant processes? One is that the photosynthesis. Second is that the respiration. Third is the absorption. Fourth is the transpiration. Fifth is the translocation. And the next is that the reproduction. Now, the photosynthesis, that is a, you know that photosynthesis. That means the formation of a food material with the help of a solar energy. Here the solar energy get converted into the chemical energy. Now this is the food product, carbohydrates. Now this is the called as a photosynthesis, in which the formation of oxygen, that means oxygen is the main byproduct. Now the respiration, that is the intake of a CO2 and the outtake of a oxygen. Now this is the respiration process, and here it also affect on the growth. Now the absorption, that means various micronutrient, macronutrient, water, which are available in the soil, it get absorbed by the root, and this is useful for to the overall growth of that plant body. If there is a scarcity of water, the plant growth is not occur properly. While as the micro and the macronutrients, which are also essential, due to that the deficiency of the micro and the macronutrient, the growth and the development of that plant body become a sustain. So this is the absorption. Next is at the transpiration. The transpiration, now what is the transpiration? That is the evaporation of a water. That means excess of water get evaporated through the leaves. That means a small number of stomatas are present on the backside of the leaves, and this with the help of the stomata, the excess of water get evaporated. Now this is essential for to the growth. Now this is essential for to the healthy plant. So this is a transpiration. Now the translocation. Now what is the meaning of the translocation? Translocation, that means here the transfer, that means here we say that the translocation of the phloem and the conduction of a water. Now the root conduct the water through the other plant parts of a body. While as the leaf produces a food material, now this food material get transferred with the help of a phloem through the other part of a body. So xylem and the phloem plays an important role in the translocation. So this is the translocation. And the last is that the reproduction. Now the reproduction, that is a with the help of the that means the production of a new production of a flower, production of a fruit with the help of the flower, with the help of the pollination process, the plant get produce the plant produces a fruit, and this fruit is essential for to the formation of a new plantlets with the help of a seed. That means seed is important. That means with the help of seed, the formation of a new plantlets. Now these are the six processes, like as a photosynthesis, respiration, absorption, transpiration, translocation, and the reproduction. Now next is that the photoperiodism. Now the photoperiodism, it is the response of a plant to the length of the day and the night. Okay, now here the one more thing is that the what is the name, that means the what is photoperiod. Now photoperiod is the relative length of the day and night. That means the actual relative length, what is the actual relative length of the day and night, we call as a photoperiod. And the one more phenomena is that the critical period. Now what is the critical period? That means plant require only a specific phase of a light and the darkness. Why? For to their flowering. So this is called as a critical period. That means plant requires specific phase of a light and the darkness for to their flowering, we call as a critical period. And the relative length of the day and night is called as a photoperiod. There are the three category of the photoperiodism. One is that the long day plants. Now the long day plant require the longer exposure of a light than the critical period. Now critical period means this is a, that means a specific phase of a light and darkness. That means when the plant require the more longer exposure of a light than the critical period, we call as a long day plants. Example is the oat, wheat, and the pea. While as the short day plants are the plants which require the shorter period than the critical period, like as a, and then and only there is a flowering. The example is that the chrysanthemum, tobacco, rice, jowar and the cotton. The one more category is that the day neutral plants. Now here these plants doesn't for their flowering they are unaffected by the any kind of the photo, there is no any kind of the photo period is required for that day neutral plant. That means the maize, sunflower, cucumber, rose, tomato, they doesn't have any kind of the photo period, any kind of the light they produce a flowering. Now look at this diagram. Now this is a short day plant and this is a long day plant. In the short day plant, this is a dotted line indicate this is a critical photo period, okay, critical night length. This is a dark period and this is a light period. Now in the short day plant or in the short day flower, when the period of the darkness, now this period of darkness is exceed, if it is a exceed, then this critical night length, okay, if now this darkness period is exceed than the critical night length, then that means this, and then and only flowering is occur. Now when this darkness is exceed than this critical photo period, then flowering is occur. If it is not exceed, then there is no flowering. Or if it is interrupted by the somewhat light and darkness, there is also no flowering. But in the long day plant, when the period of a darkness is lesser than the critical night length, at that time the flowering is occur. But when the darkness is increase in the long day plant than the critical night length, there is no flowering. But when this darkness, if there is a longer darkness, but darkness is interrupted by the light, then only the flowering occur. So this is the long day plant and this is a short day plants. Now the vernalization. Now the next concept is that the vernalization. The vernalization, it is the phenomena of induction of a flowering in a plant by exposure to low temperature. Okay, so this phenomena prevent the precocious reproductive development, basically found in the biennial plants or the monocarpic plants. That means after the flowering, they are die in the second season. So this is a flowering which is occur with the help of the induction of the flowering. Okay, induction of a induction. Induction of this flowering by the exposure of a low temperature. So the effect of the vernalization is that the when we germinated seeds, when we potted into the two pot, at that time the one pot we are giving the treatment of vernalization and the another pot we are not giving the treatment. So this is a non-vernalized plant and this is a vernalized plant. Now this plant is chilled for 1 month at 5 degrees Celsius and at the ordinary temperature, while as there is no chilling and this plant is always treated as a ordinary temperature. So what happened in that the treatment which are, that means the treatment which are giving the chilling treatment which are giving to the plants which showing the flowering and the growth, the length of that plant become increases and the good flowering is occur, while as a non-vernalized plant doesn't show any kind of a changes. So we found that the when we require the number of flowering in a within a some period, within a less time, then when we are giving the vernalization treatment, it produce a flower in a less time. This is a vernalization. Now the last concept is that the senescence. Now what is a senescence? Senescence is the process of aging in a plants. Okay, so that means it is a deteriorative process that is a naturally terminate their functional life. So it is called as a senescence. The senescence, it is also known as a biological aging, and it is a gradual deterioration of a functional characteristics. That means here the plants get age, and after after the aging, there is a death. So look at this. This is the aging of the leaf. Now this is a green leaf. Now it turns into the various color. The first stage, it is a yellowish, then brown, and the complete brown in color. Now here, the complete all the processes get stopped. The dead, that means the functionality become a stop, and so the green color, that means the photosynthesis, there is a no photosynthesis. This color become a brown, and the all function gets stopped, and that's why there is a this leaf is a deactive. Okay, so the senescences occur, and this is a deteriorative process. So this is a senescence. Now this senescence get retarded by the some factors, like as a plant hormones, that is auxin, cytokinin, gibberellic acid, polyamine. These are the some retardants which retard the senescence, while as some nutrient like as a calcium and nitrogen, when we apply on that plants, so the senescence get retarded, while as the when we provide the good supply of water and the irrigation to that plant body, at that time the senescence get retarded. When the good quality of light, and there is a opening of the stomata in the light time, at that time, as well as when the temperature is become lower, at that time the senescence get retarded. These are the some factors which are responsible for to the retardation of a senescence. I hope you understand. This is the this development process, that is a growth and development, part second. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel and click on a bell icon for watching more videos. Thank you. Thanks once again.